Hi everybody, I'm Amy from Body Fit by Amy, and today I am talking to Dr. Marcy Crouch. She is a pelvic floor physical therapist, board certified in women's health, and we are both busy moms of two. And I just wanted to talk to her about some common pelvic floor issues, some things I talk about a lot, and give you all a little bit more information from her standpoint. So, what about, how do I know if my diastasis recti is healed or fixed? We hear those terms a lot, but the reality is it can still be there. It often is, and you can still have a functioning core. So let's talk about that.
Yeah. So,
so many things.
How much time do we have? So I think there's a lot of information out there. Mm-hmm. And it's really easy kind of to get sidetracked a little bit. But what we're noticing in the literature is that we used to get really hyper about the number.
Mm-hmm.
Like how big the gap was. Like how big is the separation. And now what literature and evidence is showing us is that it's not necessarily about how big the gap is, but it's about how much tension we see across the connective tissue in between the muscles of the rectus abdominis. Mm-hmm. And if there's like stiffness there, so like if we're feeling, if we're palpating with our fingers, we're not like sinking kind of all the way down, or that there's like a nice kind of rebound when we're feeling there, and that the deep abdominals and the pelvic floor are working together.
Yes.
So there are studies that show that women who haven't had babies are presenting with like a 1 to 2 centimeter separation and asymptomatic. So I think programs or people out there that are like saying, oh, close the gap, it has to be zero, it has to be perfect, like that's probably not normal anatomy, and I don't think that that's like a realistic goal.
No.
My goals for moms are to get down to 1 to 2 centimeter without doming or tenting while we're doing these kind of like higher level activities. You know, we can get back to a plank. We can absolutely get back to a push-up if you're able to have your pelvic floor engaged the right way. There's no tenting or doming. We have good tensile strength in the connective tissue, and that the muscles are strong. Like, you can have a functional abdominal wall with, let's say, like hypothetically, a 3 or 4 centimeter separation. Like, totally normal.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think saying like zero means.
No. And really, when we look at anatomy, when you see someone with a six pack, we talk about the rectus abdominis, there is a line in the middle.
Right.
We just talked about it. That's your insertion point. So there's always, you're going to feel a little bit.
Sure.
And I, this was eye opening to me because I did get, even though I knew that it was about both, I was really focused on checking the gap, gap.
Sure.
And when I saw my physical therapist, which, you know, spoiler, I didn't go right when I should have. I waited about 6 months, which is okay.
Totally fine.
It's never too late. You know, she said, like, yes, you still have a little bit of a gap. It was down to about 1 to 2 centimeters.
Yeah.
But the strength of your connective tissue, especially in my follow-up when she was checking, is strong enough that you can go back to doing those things.
Right.
So
there's
really not a magic number or a magic way to tell.
Yeah.
It's more about something I always say, listening to your body. Yes, functioning. Because something women say a lot is, oh, when I'm in a plank, I feel like everything's falling out.
Right.
It probably means that you can't create enough tension to be doing a plank, so you want to hold off and build that strength in other ways first.
Yep. Yep.
So lots of ways to check, and that again, that's why it's important to work with a physical therapist, but you'll know, you know.
And a lot of times what people don't understand, too, is that I do a vaginal assessment, a pelvic floor assessment, for all my people that come in who are concerned about diastasis.
Yeah.
Even if they're not subjectively reporting any sort of like incontinence or pelvic pain or heaviness or prolapsy feelings, if we're working the core, we need to know what the pelvic floor is doing. Otherwise, the core exercises aren't going to be super effective all the time. Like, we need to just make sure that the whole system is working together.
Right, exactly.
And that your pelvic floor is coming in the way that it should with the deep abdominal stuff.
Yes.
And a lot of times people are like, why are you doing a vaginal exam?
Yeah.
Like, what are you doing? And it's like, just like testing muscle strength, just like any other muscle.
Yes. And, you know, we hear, you know, again, some people say, I didn't know I had it, but I just knew that I felt like I still looked pregnant 2 years later,
right,
or 3 years later.
Yeah.
But even if you don't have those feelings, it may be the source of your back pain. It may be the source of your incontinence. There are lots of other things, you know, that could happen that could be because you have a diastasis, which is another reason to get checked and to be healing all those muscles together.
Yeah.